Everyone, welcome to the show. I have an update to share about one of Trump's Capitol insurrectionists. It's time for an episode of Where Are They Now?
Martin Bledsoe was arrested.
Patrick Montgomery was in court.
Jonathan Manapa will stay in federal custody.
No, I don't take responsibility at all.
So 23-year-old January 6th defendant Riley Williams just went to trial. It didn't go so well for her. This is the woman who's accused of aiding and abetting in the theft of a laptop from Nancy Pelosi's office. In the lead up to her trial, also, I should mention, she gave the court a lot of grief. She kept violating her release conditions. Her release conditions required that she be confined to her home nearly 100% of the time. She was also supposed to stay off of the internet. However, like I said, she kept repeatedly violating those conditions. Then she and her mother were caught lying to her probation officer. They also said that someone told the FBI that he interacted with her over a video chat, which was prohibited. Also, her parole officer saw an iPad case and a charging cord inside of her vehicle. But given all of this, Williams had the nerve to request that the court minimize or modify her release conditions. She wanted them to grant her more freedom. So her request was denied, of course. And in the lead up to the trial, Williams' attorney asked that certain January 6th videos be banned from the trial. They wanted to prevent the jury from seeing any videos of the mob calling out for Nancy Pelosi because the trial started shortly after that attack on Speaker Pelosi's husband. Well, the judge denied that request, so a video was played, and one of the witnesses at the trial who testified against Williams was a top aide for Pelosi. It was a man named Jamie Fleet. And the prosecutors described to the jury how Williams was at the forefront of the mob, how she was directing people up the stairs to Pelosi's office, and they warned the jury that, quote, looks can be deceiving. And this is very true in Williams' case because she appears to be this meek, harmless, tiny girl, but this is the same woman, I'll remind you guys, who was seen wearing a mask, a very menacing looking mask, dancing around in her room and giving the Nazi salute with some really ominous music playing in the background. She's also a known follower of the America First group founded by avowed white nationalist, white supremacist Nick Fuentes. In fact, both her attorney and the prosecutor agreed that she was obsessed with Fuentes and his organization. So the prosecutors explained to the jury how Williams consumed vast amounts of right-wing election denial propaganda online prior to January 6th, and how she took control of the mob when she was inside of the Capitol. And they played a video in which Williams could be heard in Pelosi's office, and she was encouraging this man to steal Pelosi's laptop. And he did. And another video played for the jury. Williams was heard yelling for the mob to, quote, lock arms, and, quote, push, push. So this was when there was a mob that was getting ready to attack a police line. Then the jury also heard that Williams purchased a new cell phone, deleted her social media accounts, and used an industrial type of software program to wipe the contents of her computer after January 6th. But her attorney tried to paint her as this innocent young girl who, quote, just wanted to be somebody, and, quote, wanted people to notice her. And she said that Williams got caught up, quote, in a little fantasy world. She admitted, you know, some of her views are grotesque, but she tried to minimize her actions at the Capitol. And then in an attempt to prove that Williams didn't intend to obstruct the certification of Biden's win, she cited the fact that Williams posted online saying that she was storming the White House. So after deliberating for a pretty short time, the jury found Williams guilty on 6 counts: civil disorder, resisting or impeding officers, entering a restricted building or grounds, 2 counts of disorderly conduct, and parading in a Capitol building. The jury, however, was unable to come to a consensus on two other charges, which included one of the most serious felonies. They couldn't agree on whether or not Williams obstructed an official proceeding or if she aided and abetted in the theft of government property. So based on the most serious of her convictions, which is the civil disorder charge, Williams faces up to 5 years in prison, and she's going to be sentenced on February 22nd of next year. This is by U.S. District Judge Amy Berman Jackson. My guess is Judge Jackson's probably going to give her 2 to 3 years, I would say. I mean, one less wannabe Nazi off the streets for at least a couple years, I guess, I hope. But anyway, I'll keep you guys posted. I'll let you know when that goes down and what her fate is. Thanks so much for watching and listening. Please like, share, subscribe. Please donate if you can. Thank you guys so much. Appreciate all of you. Take care, and I'll talk with you soon.